So these are tissues that do change in the cold. There could also be effects on the immune system and effects on inflammation, but this is not as clear as people seem to make it. So you look in the mainstream social media and people will say, get into the cold, it's going to improve your inflammation status, it's going to improve your immune system. This is actually not proven at all.
That's what I was going to ask you, right, is about that kind of cold therapy seems to be all the rage. Is there any science behind that, or is it like this thing has just taken on a life of its own? And
extremely important question, because people seem to say that there's science behind it. And they kind of try to say, okay, this is what you do, and it improves all these parameters. Right now, there's very little backing up any of that, these statements. So there is some research kind of showing that cold could have multiple benefits. And one of these benefits that is clear is cold is a stimulant. So as soon as even taking a cold shower, or a cold bath will actually increase not only your dopamine, but actually increase stress hormones. And it gives you a bit of a rush. And this rush actually makes you feel good. And the dopamine makes you feel good, but the rush also coming from just doing that cold exposure, a cold shower would do it too. And of course, if the person feels better, that's a very important result, right? So the person's feeling better. So for me, if you think about therapy, cold does help. So, and the issue that happened is people now started pushing the envelope. So they're using some of that cold and making some statements about the effects on the immune system and inflammation. But cold is not even standardized in the way people use it. So just like if I would say exercise is good for you, well, you're going to ask me what type of exercise, how intense should I do it? How long should I do it? How frequently should I do it? Well, we don't know for cold. And some people, if you say 2 minutes in ice water is good, they're going to think that 20 minutes is 10 times better because the risks of going beyond 2 minutes are not worth it. And the damage that you're going to do to your tissues are not worth it. You can't just keep doing these cold water dips thinking that I'm not damaging tissues. And if you repeatedly expose yourself to cold temperatures, you will damage your nerves in your hands and in your feet. And this can actually be permanent. And this is well documented in soldiers, by the way, in the UK and Canada, and even in the US, extremely well documented that non-freezing cold injuries from repeated exposure to cold can actually be permanent damage to tissues.
I don't want to kind of put words in your mouth necessarily, but kind of sum it up from my understanding. It kind of seems like when we're talking about cold therapy that we know that we feel differently, right? And we know that people kind of feel energized or feel whatever, but it doesn't seem like there's any actual proof that from a biological perspective that anything is happening.
No, there's actually a paper that just came out in 2023. I just looked at it. I found it yesterday. And it's from University of Bern in Switzerland. And they showed that actually the Wim Hof method over 15 days had no cardiovascular advantages. And this showed actually very few benefits, even with the breath work and everything that was going on. Again, this is biologically, right? Does it mean that people are feeling better? I'm not discounting. And anecdotal evidence is still very good evidence. If people are feeling better, I mean, this is good. If they're not getting injured doing it, this is good. Biologically, a lot of these methods cannot be backed up right now.
Claim about cold therapy that drives you nuts the most.
I think right now, what really bothers me is more about the immune system, because we kind of put the immune system is a very complex system. And we try to simplify it by saying, okay, it's going to improve the immune system. And a lot of people have looked at, you know, the changes in white blood cells, but there's far more going on than this. And even when you're sick, the white blood cell count changes. So people are making claims based on no evidence. And I think what bothers me the most is when people, especially with no training at all, no formal training in any field, have taken a weekend course or, you know, a few courses, and they make these types of claims. Again, based on no science, or maybe based on a random paper from a predator journal that people are just trying to convince of the efficacy of cold exposure. I think this right now with the immune system is what bothers me the most,